In normal circumstances, our body maintains blood pressure within a certain level, one that ensures adequate circulation throughout the body, while maintaining the integrity of the cardiovascular system. Blood pressure must be high enough to deliver oxygen and nutrients to the tissues and organs, but not so high that it damages the blood vessels. Our body has several mechanisms for regulating blood pressure. One is the baroreceptor reflex, a neurally mediated reflex that regulates blood pressure in the short term. Baroreceptors are stretch receptors that are in the walls of the aorta and carotid arteries. When blood pressure rises, the baroreceptors are activated and send signals to the brain, specifically the cardiovascular center in the medulla. In response to this, the parasympathetic nervous system activity increases and the sympathetic nervous system activity decreases. The net effect is decreased heart rate and systemic vasodilation. Vasodilation, or blood vessel dilation, increases the area where blood can flow within the vessel, thereby decreasing systemic vascular resistance. Collectively, these actions lower blood pressure. Conversely, when blood pressure decreases, there is less baroreceptor activation. Less signals are sent to the cardiovascular center, causing it to increase sympathetic nervous system activity and decrease parasympathetic nervous system activity. This increases heart rate and cardiac contractility, as well as systemic blood vessel constriction. Together, these actions increase blood pressure. Another mechanism for regulating blood pressure is the renin-angiotensin aldosterone system, or RAAS. This system is dependent on hormonal changes that induce the transcription of genes to produce vasoactive proteins. So it is a slower means of controlling blood pressure compared to the baroreceptor reflex. When blood pressure falls, the renin-angiotensin aldosterone system is activated. The juxtaglomerular cells in the kidney release renin. Renin converts angiotensinogen, a protein synthesized in the liver, into angiotensin 1. Angiotensin-converting enzyme, or ACE, then converts angiotensin 1 to angiotensin 2. Angiotensin 2 does a number of different things. It causes blood vessel constriction within the systemic circulation. It also stimulates the adrenal cortex to release aldosterone and the pituitary gland to release antidiuretic hormone, or ADH. Together, aldosterone and ADH cause the kidneys to retain sodium and water. Increased salt and water retention increases blood volume. Ultimately, this increases cardiac output. Along with systemic vasoconstriction, this effect increases blood pressure. When blood pressure rises, the opposite happens. Less angiotensin II is produced, causing blood vessel dilation and lowering vascular resistance. The kidneys excrete more sodium and water in the urine and thus decrease blood volume. These effects lower blood pressure. In summary, blood pressure regulation involves a dynamic interplay between the heart, the autonomic nervous system, baroreceptors, the brain, and various hormonal and renal mechanisms. Together, these systems maintain blood pressure within a narrow range to meet the body's needs and prevent high or low blood pressure-related problems. In the upcoming videos, we will discuss the various classes of antihypertensive medications and how they work to reduce blood pressure. And that's it for today's pharmacology video. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel for more pharmacology content.